Investment and turnaround specialist Volvere saw profits rise in 2015 as the company was boosted by a record performance by pie maker Shire Foods. Volvere's pre-tax profit from continuing operations was $1.34 million, up from $1.2 million the year before, on revenues of $27.9 million more than double the $12.4 million in 2014. Well, joining me is the Chief Executive, Jonathan Lander. Jonathan, thanks so much for coming in. First off, just give us an overview what Volvere does.
So Volvere was floated in 2002. We're a turnaround investor. So we buy companies that are generally in some form of financial distress, turn them around, and then sell them. So there are lots of euphemisms for what we do. We're not a vulture fund. We actually try and work with companies that have got a problem which we can fix. It's a pretty rare investment opportunity on the stock market, I think, these days. I don't think there's anybody else who does it. Mm-hmm. And we focus typically on companies that are sort of requiring sort of £2 to £5 million, and they typically have turnovers of sort of £10 to £50 million. It's that sort of range.
Well, just scratching beneath the surface there, how do you go about turning around companies? What's some of the detail involved?
Well, it depends on what the company does, what mm-hmm. the problem is. The science, there's no real science to it. It's a bit of an art. When you go in, most of the time, when you look at companies that are losing money, they're losing money for a reason which you probably can't fix. They're just sort of bad businesses. If I had a pound for every printing company that I'd seen, you know, in the last 15 years, that I'd be much richer than I am if I could fix them. But they're not fixable. But most businesses that we see, we can't help. But one or two times you see something which is a bit special. So, for example, it might have a bank loan which is too big for the business to pay back. So we put the company through a restructuring arrangement, a CVA or a prepact administration to get rid of that bank loan or pay the bank some of the money that it's owed. So typically there's a thing that we look for that we can fix. So it'll be too much leverage. Maybe management team is not as strong as it could be. And those are things that we can identify and sort out.
Now, you say it depends on what type of business you're looking to invest in. Are there certain sectors or areas that you prefer over others?
We are sector agnostic, but we generally like people businesses. The businesses that most investors won't touch are the ones which don't have any assets. And people businesses, rather bizarrely, have no assets other than the people. But the best return that we get on our time, and to some extent our money, is on businesses where they're just people, because they're the ones which it's hard to finance. So that's a preference of Volvere, and our track record there has been extremely good, getting the hearts and minds of the management teams and the people that work in the companies moving in the right direction, pointing in the right direction. That gives us the biggest return. We do have, as you mentioned in your intro, a food manufacturing business called Shire Foods, which it has people in it, but also mm-hmm. it's a factory. So we do things that are out with of that area, but people is a focus.
And in terms of restructuring, you do full-scale rebuilds as well as companies that require a little tweak and a little polish around the edges.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know what a tweak is, but I mean, they all the companies that we invest in require, you know, degrees of restructuring. I mean, sometimes we'll have to relocate them, change all their offices. We had a business called JMP, which we sold in December of last year, where almost all of the offices that they were in, we left and put them in new offices at lower rents. So we can do geographical changes. We've changed the management teams many times. But generally, we work with what we have. So if a little tweak is improving the financial reporting mm-hmm. or restructuring the equity and debt package that the company has, if those are tweaks, then we do those. But it really depends upon the business. Ideally, you do the minimum that you can. Mm-hmm. We generally work with what we have, but it really depends upon the business.
Now, you mentioned Shire Foods. You've got an 80% stake in them, haven't you? What attracted you to them in the first place?
Well, I think food manufacturing is a very difficult industry. There are lots and lots of food businesses that have gone out of business in the last sort of 10, 20 years, because generally what you find is that capacity in the industry has got much greater because the technology advances that you have. You can make much more in a pie line today than you could make 10, 20 years ago. It's no longer handmade, the stuff that you buy in the shops. What attracted us to it was that a lot of the businesses that we have looked at in that area have gone out of business, but yet there are some that are left that are making good money. some of the competitors of Shire Foods. So I think the industry, whilst it's had a correction, has now got to a point where there is a sort of base of people who can make good returns on their capital. Shire Foods had a great management team. It's still run by the same management team that was there when we invested. The particular problem that it had was it got overextended with one large customer, and it had a bank that was becoming a little more nervous. So what we did was we thought that by just removing the bank from the capital structure or reducing its position, doing a few other tweaks around customers, that we could put it back on a firm footing for growth. And it has been, so in the first year that we bought it, the turnover went down to about 8.5 million. And it's now back up to about, or at the end of last year, up to about 15.5 million. So what we did was mild, I think, in terms of restructuring. It's not a business that will ever disappear in this country. Mm-hmm. So the changes were mainly around financing and identifying that it was not an industry that was never going to recover.
So that's Shire Foods. What other companies are you invested in at the moment?
So Volvere currently has is actually rich in cash. It's quite a lot of cash and not much of the subsidiaries, but we have three companies. Shire Foods, which we've mentioned. The second one, which we bought just over a year ago, is called Impetus Automotive. That's a consulting business that supplies generous consulting services, audit services to vehicle manufacturers, Jaguar, Land Rover, BMW, and also some Triumph in the motorcycle industry. We do audits of their dealers, checking that they meet the franchise agreements. We advise them on everything to do with after sales. And that's about, last year, that was for the 9-month period, was about a 12 million turnover business. And it made about £600,000. It's a business which we bought from a venture capital firm who wanted to sell it. And we've been working to improve its performance. So Impetus is our largest subsidiary today with about 200 people in it. A similar sort of turnover to Shire Foods. The other one is one we don't mention much, but it's called Cyber Defence, and it's a company that makes software for the police and government departments all around surveillance. It's a sort of sub-million pound turnover business. It's very small, but it's got a great future, I think. And what they do is they enable most of the police forces in the UK to read the CCTV, which is becoming more and more important in crime detection and prevention. Allows them to read it quickly, read the header information on that CCTV footage so they can identify where the camera is, what time it was on that camera, the stuff that you need to do to build a case, to build a case to solve or a crime or prevent a crime. So Syra is the third subsidiary of Volvere with Shire and Impetus.
That's interesting. So we've talked food, transport, and you mentioned sort of slightly tech related.
Yeah.
Is technology somewhere that you're wanting to push more into?
Well, I'm a big tech investor, so I personally invest in technology companies all the time. And Volvere came out of the sort of technology business called D2L Capital, which is a venture capital business that invests in internet companies. So my preference is technology businesses. Volvere, though, I would say, has to find a company which has got a more established business than most tech companies. So the ones that are not too far from here, around Old Street, they are pre-revenue or very small, and that's generally not the sort of thing that Volvere would invest in. We could do it, but I'd rather see a more established business with some revenues which perhaps had a distressed component to it, then we would do it. But I don't think it's a current focus of Volvere.
Tell me a little bit more about yourself. You've been involved in financial services for 25 years at least. Are you enjoying the current challenge?
I'm enjoying the challenge. Is it 25 years? My God. I like investing. So I like looking at different businesses, different sectors. The great thing about Volvere is that certainly in principle, we can invest in anything that we want, that we have experience in. That's what our investment mandate says. Our track record has been extremely good. The average growth in net assets per share in Volvere is about 16% per annum with pretty well no leverage. And that's a very good, if I do say so myself, long-term average. Mm-hmm. So I like investing, and I always like the challenge of that. Any sector, really, I like looking at it. And over time, it's one of the few things that gets better with age, is you get better at picking investments because you can spot the mistakes. You must always keep your mind open to the things which are new and not shut your mind to the fact that Facebook is actually the way that people market today, and it's not actually in newspapers. So I love the challenge of that, keeping open to fresh ideas and also looking at the old ones and casting out the bad ones. So it's very exciting. So yes, I still enjoy it at my very young age.
And in terms of financials, doubling revenues, rising profits, were you happy with how 2015 was?
Yeah, 2015 was a great year. I think the test that we generally use, because we often buy and sell businesses, is not so much looking at profits and revenues, it's looking at the growth in our assets. So the asset base of Volvere has gone to the net assets per share of £5.69. When we started in 2002, it was about 94p a share. So you're nearly six times your money. 2015 was great because we sold JMP, which boosted our net assets per share by about 34% in that year. So you can't complain about that. I think our shareholders were happy and our share price has gone up substantially since those results were announced.
And what's on the cards for 2016? What can shareholders look forward to? Anything exciting?
Anything exciting? I think we like to deliver a sort of steady as you go performance. Mm-hmm. We're continually reviewing new deals. They come in every day. We look at things. Most of the things that we see, of course, don't make the sort of printer test, which is never be able to be saved, even by Volvere. So lots of opportunities. I think the focus is currently on extending, improving the performance of Impetus and Shire Foods, because clearly they're important subsidiaries that we want to make sure are where we maximize the value. But I think it'll be a combination of continued performance in those subsidiaries and in Shire, and perhaps some new stuff.
Jonathan, it's been an absolute pleasure. We could talk all day, but I think we're out of time. Thanks for coming in.
Thank you.